Do you notice something different about this bulb? It's got five angles. Whoa. Do you know the answer to this already? Have you ever seen another five-angle bulb? No, right? Most of them are six angles, right? So why do you think this is a five-angle bulb?
So no one can.
Yeah, exactly. Because six angles is so common, right? Like someone can just find some random hole and like open it. Right, but fire hydrants, you don't want some random person meeting to walk in the street and saying, open up a fire hydrant. So that just specifically designed the bulbs to be five-sided so that your torque makes it harder to open. Anyway, just random fun fact. That's why I was sharing. No, but like, I guess the point I was trying to make was there's things that you think you may understand and know. Or sorry, there's things where you think you understand, but you really just know that and you don't fully understand that. And I would say that's the same thing for conversations with people and what they want and what they say they want. Another big key is just having empathy, trying to understand where people are coming from. So I'll give you a quick example where this is even just beyond, this is just like blood work stuff in general, right? One time I was working with a property manager from another team, and they were trying to deprecate some feature, and we were sitting down together, and he needed my help to come up with some product ideas, right? So we were chatting, and we were GVCing, and he was asking for ideas, and so I was sharing some, but he was like getting really frustrated for some reason, and like getting really upset, and like asking for a bunch of questions, and shooting down all my ideas. I was thinking about him, I was like, why is he doing this, right? Is it because he doesn't like my ideas, right? Or the same thing that's annoying him, right? But the reality was actually, no, he was just having a really bad day. And, like, there was some stuff that happened that made him really upset. And I realized after sitting there, not immediately reacting to what he was saying, that what he just needed was for me to come back and talk to him later on, because he wasn't going to be very receptive to my ideas. So it's another way of listening. Where it's beyond just building a product, but it's like, how do you use your time most efficiently, and how do you understand people that you're working with? So one of the last tips I think to really think about in terms of, where do I have that arrow there? Oh, anyways, for question statement ratio is to think about, am I listening well? Is to focus on, what are my ratio of questions to statements? So kids ask a lot of questions, right? And it's funny because beyond that, their brains just being very elastic, they're also very curious about the world. So Newsweek did this article talking about creativity crisis and talked about how kids, when they're young, they actually ask their parents about 100 questions a day. Why? Why? Why is the sky blue? Why does the car drive? You know, why does the wheel on TV turn back? Right, they ask a lot of why questions. And in many ways, that actually helps them be creative, right? Because they're curious, they're trying to understand the world around them. And I think also as kids, when you share them something, you know, they have great memory, but they also are listening, right? They're trying to really pay attention and understand what you're trying to say. And so I would almost argue that if you are a listener, and you're spending more of your time asking questions rather than talking, you actually not only understand things better, but it helps you be more creative. Here's a quote from Einstein talking about how he didn't really have special talents, but he was just curious. And so you can almost think about, like, okay, listening is just beyond hearing words, right? Listening is beyond just trying to understand people. Well, listening is really about being curious of what people have to say. Why are they saying this? I'm really curious about this person. Tell me more. Right? And that's something that I would encourage you to think about is everybody is interesting, everyone has a story, and there's something that you can learn from them. And if you listen, right, that's a really good skill to have because you can understand the world around you. A lot of great leaders are oftentimes the best listeners. Because you know, you're a CEO of the company, you don't know day to day what's going on, right? You have to listen to your employees to really understand why are things hard, why are things difficult, what is going well, right? And you have to be a good listener and actually engage with your team. So this is going back to what I was saying before, which is if you really want to be, you know, as you grow your career, as you grow to managing teams, being able to listen is a really key skill. Because otherwise, you know, your big boss is going to come into a meeting with you, and they're going to call you all inside, and they go, what is this? Why is this not going on? You're going to represent your team, and you can make something up, right? But also, if you listened, then one, you may actually know how to answer that question. I mean, I wouldn't say you have to be the one to answer it. I would actually recommend that you encourage your team members to answer on behalf of you, right? But ideally, you're listening to your team, so you know when you have to share. You know what's going on, and you know what they're going to say, and you know how to answer questions in case your teammates aren't around. So yeah, I think being present, listening actively, and finally asking good questions and asking questions are important things for listening well. What do you think? So when I first started working at Google, my manager, every single time I got into a room with them, like, we'd be talking and he'd be like, what do you think? And I'd be like, whoa, there's something going on here. And then I realized he was really smart. Because one, not only was he asking for my opinion, right? So he was asking to see what I've already thought first before, so he's gaining knowledge before he shares something. But he's also using that time to quickly think himself, right? So sometimes thinking or asking questions is just a smart idea. And he was a really, really good product manager. He was like one of those guys where, like, been at the company for maybe 3 or 4 years, got promoted every single year, and now he works at Waymo, so driving cars, you know, awesome. One of those guys, right? And that's what I learned, was to ask questions for him. So ask, what do you think? Why did you choose to do this? What do you think is a good idea? You know, tell me your thoughts about this process, right? So asking open-ended questions, digging deep and getting behind the assumption, get a comfortable silence, and don't interrupt. So just some random tips around asking good questions is, have you guys heard of open-ended questions? Yeah. So don't ask yes or no questions, but ask questions that allow people to share more than what goes beyond the surface. Dig deep, get a comfortable silence, and don't interrupt. So quick example, so we only have a few minutes left, is, you know, is this a good question? This is actually from a friend the other day. I'm curious. Pretend I'm selling ice cream and I come to you and I ask you, do you agree that this ice cream is just totally delicious? Yeah? Right. So you just answer yes or no. Any other reasons why it might not be like a great test? Right, and maybe they'll feel bad and they'll give you a false answer. Right? And there's all these studies that go into creating good surveys so that people actually can do it. So that's a really great point. Yeah. So for a leading question, like one of the big things is if you ask a question like this, what do you actually learn from? Right? Someone says yes, okay, you learn that it's totally delicious, or they say no and you learn that it's not totally delicious. Right? But you don't actually gain any more knowledge. You know? And so these are just examples from our training earlier on this week. But you know, maybe instead of asking about, like, you know, would they buy organic ice cream? You know, for example, you're trying to sell an organic ice cream product, and you don't ask them directly, would you buy organic ice cream? You just ask them about, tell me about your experience shopping for ice cream. I mean, this is tied to something in our lab which we were talking about, which was instead of coming up with a solution and asking the customer whether or not they like the solution, check the types of assumptions that you have in your solution and ask questions that help validate your assumption without actually telling them your solution directly. So in this example, you know, this was, hey, I want to create an organic ice cream product and this is my assumption, they have a problem finding it. And so instead of asking like, hey, do you buy organic ice cream, if you went out and you surveyed people and, you know, 9 out of 10 people only talked about, my biggest difficulty in ice cream is, you know, I don't have the right size for it. 9 out of 10 people didn't talk about organic ice cream. Then, you know, it doesn't really matter about what amount of organic anymore, right? Like, they might say yes or no, but that may not actually be the most important factor. So, okay, I was going to leave some time for exercise, but I think we want to leave some time left for questions, right?
Yeah. We have 8 minutes for the Q&A session. Вы можете нам сказать, давайте мы можем перевести.
You can ask about energy. I mean, like, this is just me ranting about something, or you can feel free to ask anything. My job, what I do.
Thank you so much for such an informative presentation. It's first of all. And could you share with the case when you effectively took advantage of the art of listening that helped you to solve a problem of yours?
Yeah. That's a great question. So a case in which I took advantage of listening to effectively solve a problem. So I'll tell you an example where I guess it wasn't the outcome that I would have actually wanted, but helped me see that, helped me actually plan for my time better. So, at Google, a lot of times when you're creating products, you need to get leadership. And we were working on a product in which we were trying to plan for an actual solution. And one of our tasks was to go back and come up with a solution and do some brainstorming around how we were going to actually design it. So I'm speaking in very vague terms because I can't talk about it. It's still like in process. And we were spending a long time working on it. And we went back to our management team and we shared the solution that we were presenting, right? And the leadership team was okay. They weren't really happy with their answer. They said, go back, go again, try again, and like figure out if you can do it again. So we went back, we tried to come up with another solution to solve the same problem. How do we design an architecture that is going to build the product? And we did that second time. Presented it again. Leadership wasn't that happy, right? So this is the time when, you know, maybe it wasn't that successful, but then eventually it was. But then finally, the third time went back, and we went and we asked them for their feedback, and what we realized was their opinion in the end wasn't actually about the solution. But their opinion in the end was more about time to market. How quickly would it have been to build that solution? They could have cared less, like who did it, what it looked like, or any of those other things. But what they really cared the most about was how quickly we could have gotten it done. And I think our mistake there was we were so focused on, they were trying to ask all these questions around, you know, what does this solution do? Why is this solution better? And asking all these technical details. But maybe the best thing that we should have just done earlier on was ask, like, what is your biggest concern here that you're trying to solve for? And we could have just saved a bunch of time up front and focused on how do we design a solution that is the quickest time to market. So I know that doesn't directly answer your question, but I guess it shows you how at first we weren't listening very well, or we weren't trying to actively listen and understand his needs, and then eventually when we finally did, then you know, it helped us guide us.
I have a question about other skills, about storytelling, and what do you think it's, I guess storytelling and listening is connected as, first of all, you need to improve your skills in listening. That you can improve your skills in storytelling, because first you need to learn about listening.
storytelling and listening, and oftentimes you have to first learn to listen before you can tell stories. Yeah, it's a really great point. I would say, absolutely. And one of the biggest reasons is because when you tell a story, you have to understand what connects to your audience. You have to understand what is relevant to them. And so you need to listen for what is helpful to them. What are some things that they really need? So one thing before we came and spoke at the Little House was we asked some of our coordinators, like, what are some of those important skills that people need, right? And we asked questions, and you know, we didn't have a chance to come and talk directly to you guys, but something that we heard was, hey, you know, technical skills are great. We can talk about technical skills. One thing that might be helpful is talking more about soft skills. And that's part of the reason why before I started, I actually want to kind of get a flavor of what you guys work on, what you guys do, because, you know, a lot of my examples are maybe a little bit more work-oriented, and I know that you have some experience working, right? But, like, for example, if I had come into a room and I had asked you guys, like, where are you guys from, and you guys all said we're students and we have no work experience, then it would have been very likely that any of the stories that I told not have made any sense, right? So, yeah. So yes, and yes.
What's getting into the process of one last question?
You told me that you are learning to listen, and how do you practice, how do you learn that skill, where do you get resources? it's a big issue. And asking good questions is a very needed skill, and how do you improve it?
It's a good question. The question was, how do you improve listening?
Yeah.
It's an important skill. It's really hard. You know, I don't know. And that's part of the reason I put together this presentation, because I was like, how do I improve? I would say, as with a lot of soft skills, I've learned best from examples around me. So this is something that I feel like throughout my career is finding people that you want to learn from, finding people that you want to model. And a lot of the best leaders that I see are people who are good listeners, and I try to get close to them. Try to work on projects with them. Right? I want to work on projects with people who I think are great leaders, are good listeners, who really know how to identify customer problems. That's how I work on it, just getting exposure to it. Because, I mean, I'll be frankly honest, right? Like, it's sometimes the best influence are the people that you surround yourself by, right? And if you sit around with a table of people who are just talkers and never listen, and I find myself falling into this pitfall all the time, then I try to talk. I try to like interject my own opinion, right? Because then I feel like I'm not being heard, and then I have to interject my opinion. But then what happens is then you learn a bad habit, because then you think, oh no, I have to talk over people to be heard. But it didn't really matter, because I probably would not have been heard in the first place, regardless of what I said, right? So it's a long way of answering. I think it's just, think of the good listeners in your life, right? Learn from them, watch them, like my manager, right? What are the things that he does that are so smart, right? And I think that's a lot about the workplace, too. School can prepare you for technical skills, but it's the people skills that really help you actually succeed the most. Yes.
Спасибо огромное.